I think it's kind of a universal story. I mean, typically the guys in Vietnam, what separates these guys from other wars is that they were going about their normal lives, and they would receive a letter from our government saying that, you know, guess what, you have to report, you know, 6 weeks from now. You're obviously entering the military. They were basically, you know, plucked from their typical lives, and their lives have changed forever. So I think with these guys, it's not just a story about Charlie Company. It's a story about men that were, their lives were disrupted for, you know, a year. And it's not even a great term to say disrupted, because their lives were changed for years. I mean, these guys will never be the same. The guys that were drafted in Vietnam, the guys that, you know, they were, you know, in one moment they were going to, you know, their high school dances, they were hanging out with their friends, they were drinking beers, etc. And, you know, a month later they were off to a country that was totally foreign to these folks, and they, you know, they had to adapt. They spent a year, you know, year-long tours, and when they came back, they were just thrust into an America that was totally unfamiliar to them. So, you know, again, you know, we're highlighting the story of Charlie Company, but it was a universal story. It wasn't atypical to the guys that experienced Vietnam. So he was a good choice. Regardless of what folks think of Charlie Sheen, he is a proud American. He is a patriot. He donated the last few years over $1 million to the USO. His salary for the narration for Brothers in War was narrated or was donated to the USO. So again, he received no fees for his narration. Everything was donated. Again, I think it was a good choice. He regardless of what folks think of Charlie, it was a good choice. I think with the draft, you have to look at it, you know, I think Vietnam was the perfect storm. It was, you know, what was going on in the 60s, you know, Vietnam, et cetera. So I think today the draft, it would not fly. But in the 60s, I guess, I remember I was too young for Vietnam, but I remember living standing in my parents' living there and watching killed in action and the draft numbers being popped up on the screen. And it was, to me, it was kind of surreal. But I think you have to put a perspective on what was going on in the 60s. I think today it wouldn't be the case. But, you know, again, it was a product. A lot of what we, you know, think in terms of the 60s. Again, it's just a different time.